Right, you'll have to bear with me. This is multiple attempts now. I've been fumbling over my words today, so I apologise in advance if this video is totally gobbledygook or there's any weird silences. So right now, that's out of the way. Let's crack on. What is this? This is Big Yellow. I've not been doing much lately. I've been had a very busy 6 weeks, 6 or 7 weeks, so I've not done a lot of RC. I've dug this puppy out of my loft and decided to give him another go. Now, those who haven't been on my channel for a long time or just recently subscribed, you may not have seen this in its original forms. There are some videos of it you could go back and check if you want. That would be very nice for me, get my numbers up. If not, brief history. It started out as an extended Tamiya Blackfoot two-wheel drive. I just bolted two chassis together, the front at the front and the gearbox at the rear. It was quite a lovely thing to drive. It didn't go very fast, so it didn't roll over. Fun, but yeah, you know, you get excited about things. I saw the Stampede VXL, bought one, extended that. That was a huge amount of fun and smashed itself to pieces. So shoved it in the loft, come back to it later, thought four-wheel drive this time, so I bought an Emaxx roller. It became an extended Emaxx, again a lot of fun. Then I put that under an FG shell, gave it a lot more power, and that was great fun. And that's also gone. I move on, I repurpose things, I never leave something intact for everyone. Anyway, right, it then became a solid axle. I used the Emaxx gearbox in the front. I had it fitted in here. Used a transfer case and with solid axles. It was a lot of fun. Had its limitations. It wasn't quite a crawler. It wasn't quite a basher. It wasn't quite anything, so I thought. I've took these solid axles off and put them on the 1/6 scale Excursion, which is going to be slower and more purposeful, so that works for that. This is now an Emaxx again. I made a new chassis plate for it. The gearbox was always going to be an issue, and I've tackled that. It's in, but not without its issues. As you can see, we've got full Emaxx front and rear. I said to say front and rear. Keen-eyed Mushy will see something back there. I'll come to that in a moment. What is the plan for this? I've got the gearbox in, but as you can see, the body doesn't sit on the chassis straight, and those motors are touching the back bulkhead if I sat it down properly. If I really squeeze it in, I can ram it in, squash the motors flat, squash the wires flat, cover the vents. I don't really want to do that, but I do not want to cut that bulkhead either, so I've got a bit of a quandary. I think I'm going to have to cut the bulkhead to make this work. I really wanted to leave this shell intact in case I ever wanted to shift it on or was bored with it. But I've already cut all the front end out, so I suppose we're past that already, aren't we? Yeah, realistically, I'm going to have to cut that bulkhead. I'll keep the bulkhead, then I can glue it back in later, maybe. I don't need to cut it all. I may make... oh, that's not a bad idea. I might make a toolbox for the back, and I can put a fan in there, and the back... Okay, plan has been formed. I can put the a toolbox in there, put the battery in it and a fan, and have the motors stuck in there from that. That'll keep them nice and cool. The motors are up top notch anyway, so I need to replace them at a later date anyway. So I was hoping to get that done first, and then I didn't have to cut the bulkhead if I get two smaller motors in there. Yeah. Right, so what's the plan? As you can see, the wheels jut out a little. It's got a monster truck stance. I don't want a monster truck stance. I want a slightly lifted road going street truck, like any good old American would drive to work. I don't mind it being a little wider. I can put some arches on to cover that, so that's not a big problem. But they really, really do. The entire wheel sticks out. Now, these are standard Emaxx wheels, the 3.2s. I had these 2.2 tyres that are now superfluous to requirements, so I was thinking of stretching them over these. They're not really scale tyres per se, but they're not wildly toy-like monster truck like either, so I think I could get away with that. If I stretched them over this, they'd probably be about that profile, so they might look more like a road tyre, like an all-terrain tyre rather. Being in the UK and driving a little Ford Focus, I don't really know much about pickup trucks, so I only know what I see on videos online. So forgive me if any of this is total bullshit to people who drive these trucks for real. My apologies. Right, so what else have I been up to? Sneak peek, the Tamiya Blackfoot has new wheels. Now, I'll come to the details of that in another video, but they're actually Tamiya Lunchbox wheels. There's many practical reasons for that. They're just slightly smaller than a Blackfoot wheel, but hell of a lot cheaper, so there you go. Right, so reveal time. I've had a little haul. It was my birthday recently. I got some money for my birthday, so I've bought some stuff. Right, now, I bought this a while ago for the Chevy up there, because I took it out for a crawl bash, a crawler meet with some bods from a crawler group, and failure to launch. It died in the boot of the car. It never saw the dirt. I took the Land Rover and that one was supposed to be for my daughter to drive, and so we shared the Land Rover. I was, to say pissed is an understatement. I put a lot of time and effort and money into that, and then it didn't work. So I bought this for it. I was just going to stick it on the original ESC, but I've got the 1080 G2. There's been some upgrades to this, which I don't really know much about. I know you can manually select reverse from the remote now. So you pull the trigger to go forward, select reverse, pull the trigger to go in reverse, rather than that weird sort of pull, brake, reverse thing that you have to do with remotes. So I'm looking for us. I mean, I drive a car. I don't push my, lift my pedal, my accelerator pedal to go in reverse in the car. So yeah, that will work. Like I say, it's been a long time since I had any new kit, so I don't even know how that works. So we'll have to research that. Now, the one I'm most excited about is this, the Fusion SE 1800. I wanted one of these at Christmas, and everywhere was sold out, so I spent my money on other stuff. Now, I hoped that by my birthday came around in September, they would be back in stock, and back in stock they were. It's not the cheapest motor I bought at £90, but it is what it is. Everything goes up in price. There were £75-80 when they were new, so they've only gone up like £10-15 overall from when I first saw them to now. So waiting that 6 months actually was sort of beneficial. Right, now this was for my Land Rover, the 1/8 Land Rover, so that I didn't have to have an ESC. I could just stick the motor on it. But I've since found out that the gearbox is the weakest part of that Land Rover, and I haven't upgraded the gearbox. I've upgraded the axles and the drive shafts, but there's no point putting a super powerful motor on it until I update the gearbox. So I may be putting this in the Ford Excursion, because it's got a 2-speed FTX gearbox in it, and this would be perfect for that right now. I just need a servo for the 2-speed gear change. The reason I'm not putting it on Land Rover is because the gearbox is in the middle here, between the chassis rails, the motors in the back, and so there's no transfer case. The gearbox is where the transfer case goes. So what I want to do is put a front mounted motor and a transfer case in the Land Rover, and that's as bulletproof as my budget will allow. I know it's not with cheap Chinesium axles and they're going to be the cheap Chinesium gearbox as well. It's not going to be 100% bulletproof, but it's tougher than it was when I bought it, so that'd be good enough. Right, so 10-minute video. I've made a build series on the Blackfoot in the background there. I've done some stuff to it, some unusual and unique stuff that I don't think anybody else has done. So I've already said too much. So that's it. Oh yes, the lighting. Just a few more minutes if you'll bear with me. It had these lights that had a little circuit board on the back with an SMD for each one. It looked cool, but they were just like a visual light. They weren't really bright enough to shine anything in front. So I've got some of... I bought some of these ages ago. These are 4.5 volt ones, 4.5 volts. Now, if I'm running upgraded electronics in this, I'm hoping to run... I'm going to buy some 6 volt ones anyway. They've got more SMDs in, so I'm hoping they're brighter. You can buy a pack of 10. So, 6 up there and 4 in the headlights. That'll be bright as. Proper bright as. So I'm hoping that's all the lighting it will need. I won't need any additional light bars. I could run them from 4 AA battery pack and sit it in the back in with the in the toolbox and put in the LiPo. So that could be awesome, actually. I need to sort out the dash lighting because all the instruments light up. But when I took it out in the snow the other Christmas, I knacked all that. So I'm going to have to redo that. I want to put lights. I want all the lights to work. But all these lights, I may... All the auxiliary lights, like marker lights and stuff. I might run all those from a light kit, a cheap light kit. And then that way, that's all easily wired. Right, so there we go. That's what I'm up to. I think I've about covered everything. Yeah, next video, I'll cover the like mini Clod Buster. Because the Blackfoot wheels that were on the Blackfoot can now go on there. I've found some Clod Buster bits in boxes for it. So there we go. Right, thanks for watching, peeps. Hopefully next time you see this, it'll be working. Thanks for watching. Bye.